Hey my lovelies, welcome back to my channel. Hope you're all having a lovely day today and welcome to my new subscribers. Thank you for being here, and if you're just popping in or you're having a nose, please consider subscribing. I would love to have you be part of the family. So today's reading is a bit different. I've never done this before, but do you know what? I took inspiration from quite a lot of your comments and a lot of questions that, you know, people want to know, and they still question themselves about it, is why was I treated the way I was treated, you know? I mean, I think we all ask ourselves that. So this is what the reading is about. So why did you get treated the way you did by, say, an ex or a relative or a friend? We'll see what comes out in the piles. So group one, we have the blue owl. Group two, we have the green owl. Please don't ask me what the cards are because I don't know. And group three, we have the pink and yellow owl. So don't forget, take what resonates, okay? And these are energies, so can be male, female, or whatever you resonate with, okay? And if it's not your pile, not your story, choose another pile. So I'll see you there. Hey, group one. So if you chose the blue owl, this is your reading. So let's have a look. So spirit, tap me into group one, please. Tell me, please, spirit, the person on group one's mind. Why did the person hurt group one? What was the reasoning behind them hurting group one? So the person on group one's mind. So we have, oh, just bear with me, this is death. Okay, let me just see if that's in shot because I've changed the table. Well, the cloth, and just tied it up and dusted, as you do. So the person on group one's mind, why did this person hurt group one? Star card. So we do have Scorpio and Aquarius here. Okay, just from these two cards, group one. Okay. There was something about you, group one, okay, that you like had some sort of star quality, okay? Some of you could have been in the limelight, some of you could have had a platform, some of you could have been well known. You achieved something really big for yourself, okay? You had star quality. Even if you walked in a room, group one, heads would turn. Now, I feel like when this person got with you, you wasn't in the star quality energy, okay? But then all of a sudden, once you started to receive recognition, maybe some attention, star quality, this person didn't like the transformation in you. So I'm picking up maybe some kind of jealousy here, that they felt intimidated by you and maybe not on your level. Maybe they never admitted this to you, okay? So tell me more about this death and star card here. So we do have the page of swords. No, sorry, the page of wands. So I'm just getting used to these cards because they are new. Tell me more about this death and star card here, please, spirit. Ace of Wands. Yeah, you've achieved something so wonderful for yourself. You learned your craft, okay? You studied really hard. It may not even be in the limelight, okay? It could be a job where you were recognized for your talents, okay? For your creativity or your mind. You know, you're someone that is very very clever, okay? And you worked and studied really hard to get into this position of where you are today, which is, you know, like a new career, a new beginning, something that you were so passionate about here that you followed your dream. You'll get all your dreams came true. But this energy here, the one that hurt you, felt like you stabbed them in the back. You betrayed them. They felt emotionally, okay, because this is your mind. This is not even your feelings here with the swords. This is what was going on in this person's mind, that basically, I'm not good enough for group one. I feel beneath group one. I've not amounted to anything here. So I feel like this person done a lot of projection or a lot of put downs as well. I really need, no, actually, no. Tell me, spirit. So, this is the overall answer to the question. You know, the person on your mind, why did they hurt you? It was over your success. The transformation in you. Maybe you two were, when you got together, you know, when you get together with someone like me and my partner, when we first met, we both had nothing. And then he started a business, you know, and now, touch wood, you know, I mean, amazing things happened for him and for us, actually, should I say, because, you know, partnership. But I feel like this energy here, like the fact that you two were struggling or you didn't have much. I'm just picking up such a bitter energy here. Wow. So what did this energy do to group one? What did they do to hurt group one? So we have, I'm going to move that over. Let me just see if that's in shot. Yep. So we have, I'm getting used to these bloody cards. Out, the Lovers, the Moon. Is that the Moon? Yes. I'm so proud of myself. I'm so sad. Oh, please ignore me. And then we have that's Temperance. Yeah, that's Temperance. I'm sure that's Temperance. Oh God, I should have looked at these cards. Right, that's the Fool. That one's obvious. And then we have the Hierophant. Yeah. And then the Ten of Cups. So you could have had a family with this person, okay? Just, or you could have been married to this person. We do have the Hierophant. We do have the Ten of Cups here. You built a home with this person, okay? There was love between both of you here, okay? At one time. Yeah, and we even have the Lovers here as well. It's like, so we do, there's a lot of major arcana here, guys. This was something that major, like, was a major event in your life, okay? Something that affected you deeply. You know, it's like maybe you've not even got over this, because we do have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 major arcanas in here. So we do have Sagittarius, we do have Taurus, we do have Pisces, and we do have Gemini here. So, bear with me, okay? The question was, what did they do to you? The, It's like you didn't see the change coming in this person that hurt you, okay? It was like it gradually happened, but then you started seeing this person changing over time. And I feel like this person kept a lot of their feelings hidden and then would just lash out at you instead of actually communicating in the way they felt. Maybe they felt stupid communicating. So yeah, they'd cover it up with lying. Just bear with me a minute here. Tell me about the Lovers and the Moon. I need to clarify these cards. Tell me about the Lovers and the Moon, because sometimes with the Lovers and the Moon, that could be showing that maybe this person had a secret partner on the side, third party on the side that you wasn't aware of. That's why I want to clarify this. Four of Cups, King of Coins, and the Ace of Coins. Okay, you're already confusing me. Ten of Coins. Whatever you've done here, you've done something that's literally guaranteed wealth here. So for some of you, if you've got 10 year, is that what you call it? I don't know, I'm not from America, but something like that. But this is guaranteed success, okay? The money's flowing in. You know, look at the coffers here. But their emotions, their feelings were hidden here about how they felt about your success here. We've got the King of Coins, who is doing very well in the business world, okay? Financially successful, stable, you know, very grounded energy here. And this is your energy. You know, you were able to buy a new home, you know, maybe your job took you elsewhere, maybe you had to travel with work. But instead of getting the answers of what I'm trying to get from this energy here, which is being very stubborn, I'm just getting the energy bitching about the fact how you are so successful. This energy's not really coming through and admitting to me or to you what they did. I'm going to keep fighting to get the answers. I'm going to try and use different tarot cards to see whether I get the answers that I'm looking for. But all I can see is such bitterness here. It's like you took a chance on something here and it paid off. It financially paid off, okay? The success is guaranteed, you know? But this person, this partner of yours, was so bitter about it that they became unfulfilled. It's like an adult child, you know, when you're not paying this like the person you're with, we've all had one of them, you're not paying them enough attention, so they sulk. So we do have Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn as well, but it's just like, it's brought, your success brought about a lot of peace. I mean, you can turn this around, okay, guys, because like I say, you can sometimes flip it. So it could have been maybe your person changed through their success and then started treating you badly, okay? So take what resonates, but I'm going down the lines of you were the one that was successful. This is the person that didn't like your success. So I'm going to get some other tarot cards because this is getting on my nerves. I want to know what this person did to you. Actually, not that one. So Spirit, tell me please, for group one, the person on group one's mind, what did they do to hurt them? What did they do? Thank you. Oh, the High Priestess in reverse. Okay. They were very ignorant. They were holding back with something here. And also Spirit is very peed off with this energy here that's hiding right now. And I feel like this is why the moon is here. This person had like a two face. You know, sometimes in a on the moon card, it has a face on it. So I'm picking up this person's very two face. This person wasn't balanced at all. Their mind, their emotions, the way they thought was just all over the place. Why is the High Priestess in reverse? What's the High Priestess in reverse, Spirit? Four of Wands, which was just on the back of the deck. The reason the High Priestess is on in the reverse here, guys, is because spirits block this person from any psychic powers, any intuition, any protection. Because this could have been your twin flame, okay? And this twin flame didn't treat you very well here. Didn't appreciate the success that you achieved here. Didn't support you in this. You gave this person a beautiful start in life. You know, and if this is, you know, sometimes men can be a bit, sorry if some of you men are watching. I don't mean this in any disrespect, but there are some men, okay, don't jump down my throat, that do find it, you know, they don't find it right that the woman is the one that has achieved so much. You know, some men find it that they're not, you know, they should be the protector, they should be the one providing here. So there's no disrespect, but this is what I'm picking up with this energy here. You know, you're the Queen of Wands, who is someone very strong. You know, when you set your mind on something, you know, the goal that you were after and you were chasing, no one's going to stop you here because you are very strong. But this person put you in the Nine of Swords, which was having sleepless nights, a lot of anxiety, a lot of worry, stress, grief. Tell me about the Nine of Swords. You know, you two could have bought a lovely home together as well, you know. Because with the Ace of Pentacles, which we've got the Ace of Pentacles there as well, and the Four of Wands here, you know, that can be buying a home. But I feel like this person didn't like the fact that it was you that was the one that was providing. Tell me about the Nine of Swords. There we go, finally getting some answers. I'm just stubborn. We've got the Devil energy. This person would mess with your mind. They would belittle you, and I feel like the reason they belittled you was to make you feel stupid, make you feel that you weren't worthy, okay? Trying to knock you off your throne here, you know, this confidence. They didn't like that about you, Group One. They were intimidated by that. They were threatened by your success and your personality, how strong you were. So this person would, like I said, belittle you, you know, put you down, cause trouble, maybe start arguments for no reason at all here. This person may have ended up with some sort of addiction, you know, to try and drown out his mind or her mind. Tell me about the Devils. We have Capricorn, Leo, Aries, Sagittarius as well. Tell me about this Devil here, sorry. Swords. Tell me about the Devil. So maybe, you know, at least you've got answers here, Group One, if this resonated with you, because maybe it was that you didn't really know why. I mean, and I'm telling you, it was the success that you achieved, this stardom that you achieved here. This person felt beneath you, and that is not your problem. Maybe they never told you, Tower. Confusion. This person put you in a state of confusion. This is clarifying the devil here. Like I said, they would mess with your head here. Like, literally. I feel like, you know, I'm picking up you'd come home feeling really excited about something from work or whatever you achieved that day, and you wanted to share it with your lover here, and this person would literally just smash that to the ground. Okay, that's the tower. They would literally just say something or do something that would just make you feel like, what's the freaking point? You know, make you feel like the Nine of Swords here. And just hearing it was like, no matter what you did, you couldn't do anything right. Tell me about the Tower and the Devil. Yeah. Four of Swords. Seven of Pentacles and the Hierophant. Again, yep, your partner drained you emotionally. This was all emotionally, like, inflicted emotionally, okay? This person would literally pick at your self-esteem, pick at your ideas, pick at your success. It was just like constantly putting down, putting down, putting down. You know, and you tried to have patience with this person because you were committed to this person, you know. Once you, group one, you were committed to someone, you were committed to them. But this person wore you down emotionally. You know, they could have been gaslighting you, you know. It just was, it was cruel. It was really, really cruel. And you did, you tried to be patient with this person, you tried to be understanding, but it just, I think it got to the stage that you just was like, I can't do this anymore. So tell me, Spirit, does this person have any regrets? Chariot, sort of Cancer. Does this, I'm not even asking anything, Six of Pentacles, does this, wow, honestly. King of Swords in re- Ooh, you may have been dealing with a narcissist. Blah. I asked if this person had any regrets. Yeah, they do. The regrets, I couldn't even get it out properly. The regrets of the way they treated you, okay? Yes, they do. They hugely regret treating you the way they did. They regret you walking away from them. This person, you know, Tower resonates. This person could have left you, but I feel like it was more you left them in the end. They wish they could have actually given to you, you know, and supported you on this journey. They now have this huge regret of not treasuring you as their partner, as well as the hard work that you put into this success that you've achieved here. And they wish they could change this. But I'm telling you now, with the King of Swords in reverse, this is just not a nice person. So we've got Gemini, Libra, Aquarius here. Not a nice person at all. This is someone that is very aggressive and can be very brutal at times, you know, controlling, rude. This is someone that, oh my goodness. This is someone that would, like, go crazy. This is what I was trying to say here, like, the Tower here. It was like this person would lash out, but in such a crazy way. Like I said, with the Two of Pentacles here, their mind was just all over the place. And they were irrational at times that even, I feel like this energy didn't even understand half of the crap that was coming out of their mouth or their actions half the time themselves. Yeah, this energy like to dictate to you, you know, tell you what to do. And I feel like this is why spirit is very angry with this person, because, you know, like I said, they've got no spiritual protection at the moment because of their behaviour towards you, group one. Tell me about this King of Swords in reverse. Yeah, here's Ten of Cups again. You, oh wow, okay, thank you, spirit. Oh, look at this, we have a couple here. We have our pair right here. Yeah, world completion. This is lovely, okay? Their punishment, okay? Their karma, whatever you want to call it, is having to now watch you, because we do have the Page of Swords. They are watching you, okay? They're watching you enjoy your life. I said karma, karmic justice here, because an injustice was done to you guys. They have to now watch you be in the Ten of Cups with somebody else here. You went into a new beginning with somebody else. We do have the Lovers again, okay? You're with someone else. You're very happy. You have your pair here, which is the Queen and King of Wands, okay? You two love each other fiercely. You're very loyal to each other. You support each other, okay? You encourage each other. You learnt your... This was a big learning curve for you guys, okay? But this is a life lesson that this person has not learned yet. Maybe they have learned their lesson, who knows, okay? But this is a lesson to them now, having to watch you enjoy your life with somebody else, okay? Enjoy the success with somebody else. You learned from this, they learned from this. This is a chapter that came to a close. You're done with this. But like I said, there are certain people that do tend to wonder why that person that was supposed to love you and care for you would treat you like crap, you know? Because sometimes we don't get those answers. And if some of you were confused about why, there's your answer right there. This person felt small. So it's a really sad way to treat someone, you know? If anything, they should be lapping it up. So yeah, I'm gonna get some oracle messages from this energy as well, see what they want to say. So tell me more about this energy here, spirit. What do they want to tell group one? Okay, what do we have? I said narcissist, didn't I? Narcissism. I wasn't getting what I wanted from you, so I left to get it somewhere else. So like I said, I did say at the beginning, they may have had someone secretly, they may have been cheating with somebody else here, but this energy is very closed off. I'm surprised they even got this little bit out of them. So then we've got twin flame. I said twin flame, did I not? Your guides want you to know they're your twin flame and they need time to grow. Give them time to reflect and change. I don't think you even really care anymore. You know, it can be a false twin flame. Pessimism. I felt like I would never meet your expectations. Now, this is the thing here. I don't feel like you told this person to go off and do something better. I don't feel like you pushed them to do something better, you know. This is how they were feeling. Because they couldn't meet your expectations or the level that you were at in your career or business or whatever it is that you do, group one. But that's their problem. That was never your problem. Narcissism. This is normal behaviour for me. Most allow me to get away with it. And I feel like you let them get away with it for quite a while. I'm running out of space here. See what else they want to say. Okay, that fell out of my hand. I'll take it. There are feelings of anger inside me that I need to release before I explode. Yeah, and I feel like they are still hanging on to this anger, but I feel like it's now having to watch you have this beautiful life with somebody else here while they just look on. I shouldn't laugh, but hey ho, you know, that's the way it goes. I cannot listen to your voice, it affects my soul. I don't understand what you see in me. I don't feel attractive. So maybe that's a part of their insecurities with the moon energy there as well. They were feeling insecure. Maybe they felt unattractive. Maybe you had this look about you, group one, as well. You know, star quality doesn't just mean success. It can mean that you are very beautiful, okay? Like I said, you can go into a room and heads turn, okay? Rejecting you was protecting myself. I was being selfish. I am distracting myself to avoid thinking of you. And then we have here, my pride and ego got hurt, so I wanted revenge. I wanted you to hurt too. But boy, did you hurt group one. I mean, like, this person took it above and beyond, okay? So let's get this for you guys, okay? Not for this energy here. This is for you guys. Judgment. I understand that everybody has their own unique path and challenges. And that's, you know, we all have a path that we have to take. We all have to go through grief. But it makes us better people. I think it does. You do get the odd one or two that holds on to resentment. Forgiveness. I acknowledge that harboring resentment blocks my flow of love. So spirit really wants you to forgive this energy, okay? Stop holding on to resentment, because it will stop the flow of love that you should be receiving, you should be giving, okay? I know it's easier said than done, you know. Oh, look, love. I commit to the practice of seeing the good in all things. So, you know, you are someone I feel like you do love unconditionally, okay? You don't expect anything from anyone here. And, you know, you're in love now over here as well, group one, which is beautiful. I just want to get some of these. I'm being called to these. Let's see. Tell me, the person on group one's mind. So cheating, there's heavy flirting via text or sexting taking place, perhaps even more. So this is what I'm saying, I do think this, there was cheating. You know, I said about lies, covering something up, you know, maybe some of you were aware of it, some of you may have had an inkling of it, you know. Abuse, mental abuse, they gaslit you or send mixed signals, yep. That's exactly what this energy did to you guys. And I'm doing your reading. I mean, I've taken my asthma pump today, but all of a sudden my chest has started hurting. And I said about anxiety, my chest is feeling really, really tight. So this is what I'm saying. I feel like you guys suffered with such bad anxiety and mental torture from this energy that it put you in this, in, you know, it made you have anxiety attacks. It's like, I feel like I've just seen you guys tiptoeing. You know that saying, walking on eggshells? That's what I don't know why I've just seen you lot tiptoeing, but that's what I feel like you had to do around this energy, because they were so bitter. So bitter. Arrogant narcissist, constantly seeking attention and act as if they're superior. And also, what I'm picking up as well, I feel like group one, you may have got a lot of attention from male, you know, admirers, or female admirers, if you're male watching this, you know, or, you know, whatever you resonate with. So you would have got a lot of attention from other people. And, you know, maybe people would flirt with you and what have you. And this energy would make you feel like you'd done something wrong when you were the innocent party as well. Oh, calm down. All right, let's get them. Seeing as they flew out, put them there. So, let's see what we've got. We've got cheating again. The opportunist, this cheating heart will have sex with anyone that is willing. Wow. So maybe there was strong cheating, guys. Online flirting, social media, or dating sites. So maybe they had an online thing going on with someone or someone's. Then we've got liars, lies, lies, vindictive, they are lying to cause harm or to get revenge. And I said they were lying to you. And then we've got secrets. Hidden in the closet, some very serious addiction to prostitutes, gambling, or other expensive habit. And we do have the devil energy, which that is the devil energy. Well, some of the devil energy. Just drop me bloody thingy. Let's get a message from your angels. So we have Serafina. I am the angel of families. A happy change or addition is coming to your family. So some of you, you know, we do have the Ten of Cups here. Some of you could be expecting Some of you may have already had a child, or you know, your family life is just really happy. Okay? And I want to give you guys a little boost here with a love sketch card. Okay, Spirit, you're taking the mic. Come on. We don't want the whole deck. God. Anyways, so what we got? Back together. You'll find your way back to each other when the time is right, and you will soon realize the space that was created was to allow your love to take a different form. So maybe some of you don't start freaking out, okay, may end up back together, okay, because twin flames, I've said this before, one is working at a different level to the other one. Okay, we're at a different part in our life than our twin flame. So some of our twin flames, they need to catch up. So this is some of you. Okay, I think just like a tiny little bit of you, okay. Obsession, addicted to you. Is it love, obsession, or infatuation? Ask yourself if you can slow down or not allow thoughts of them to consume you and just let love naturally unfold. So some of you could be really obsessed with this person, or having obsessive thoughts, maybe of why they treated you like this. But then we can take this the other way around, that they're obsessed with you, okay? They're infatuated with you. We do have the spying card. And we have dunno. Something is off about this story. Get some more info before making a decision. Not saying it's bad, but you want to be certain, okay? We've got motherhood again. That's twice now. So take this time to mother your babies. Oh. Creative projects or interpretorial ventures. But more than anything, don't forget to mother yourself. That's lovely. Right, let's get the question cards. Think of your question or ask your question out loud. So for group one, Spirit. The first card out is yes, you got it. Okay, yeah, I'm gonna take that. Yes, you got it. So group one, I'm gonna leave it there. I hope you like this reading. Don't forget to comment down below if you want to leave a comment, and don't forget to hit like it. I appreciate you guys, it helps the channel. And you have a lovely day. Much love, guys. Hey, group two. So if you chose the green owl, this is your reading. So let's have a look. So Spirit, tap me into group two. The person on group two's mind, why did they, seriously, you do, this is happening in group one. I was just about to say, why did they hurt you? Eight of swords. Why did, okay, someone wants to speak. King of Swords. Eight of Cups. Three of Cups. So the question was, the person on your mind, group two, why did they hurt you? You were the Empress. Empress tends to get treated like crap, basically. To become the Empress, the Divine Feminine, whether you're male or female, okay, you have to go through a lot in life to become the Empress, okay? So a lot of heartache, you know, sometimes abuse, rough childhood, you know, I can go on. And so the Empress is very empathic. She never loses that. And I'm saying she because she is a she card, okay? Because it just makes life easier when doing tarot readings. So basically the Empress, she will forgive. And she will keep forgiving and keep forgiving. And this was the case with this energy here. They knew that you would forgive them. They knew that you would be sympathetic to their problems or their behavior. You know, I feel like you try to fix this person because that's what the Empress does. But then you push the Empress too far and the Divine Feminine will tell you to bog off, basically, that I'm done. This person, it's actually quite disturbing, group two. This person enjoyed seeing you confused, depressed. This is I'm sorry to say, a sick individual here. This is somebody that got a kick out of seeing your suffering. And this was someone so intelligent, okay? The King of Swords can be a narcissist, okay? So you could have been dealing with a narcissist, but not sure yet. But from what I'm seeing here, is because this King of Swords was so intelligent in the way they manipulated you, it's like mind control. I'll be shocked. I'll be very surprised if the devil don't come out. And you know why they treated you like this, group too? And you know, this is why I'm doing this reading, because like I said, there is a lot of people that still have a lot of unanswered questions of why. Why would they do that? Why would they treat me like that? I loved them so much. You know, these are the comments that I'm getting. And I get it, guys. I've been there myself. This energy here wanted you to leave. So instead of being a grown up and saying to you that I don't love you no more, I don't want to be with you no more, this energy would mess with your mind, confuse you, to get you to leave. So maybe there was some kind of financial reasoning behind this. You know, maybe you had assets together and it was easier if you had walked away, than that way maybe they didn't need to pay out more, or you know, this was a selfish reason behind this. So we do have Gemini, Libra, Aquarius. Now we do have the Three of Cups. The Three of Cups is talking about reconciliation, sometimes third party. So maybe this energy would tell you to go, but they say, no, I've changed my mind, let's get back together. And this is where it's like an illness with this person. I was with a person like this, a narcissist like this, for 5 years. And the things, and I was young, so I was young and dumb. I didn't even know what a narcissist was back then. That was my early, like, 20s. I'm 50 now. But I've never forgot the games, the mind games that this ex of mine would play. And I don't know, he watches my channel, the creep. But yeah, the mind games that he would play, and then he would actually start laughing. This is what I'm picking up here. That this person would actually get satisfaction out of your pain. But because you were the Empress, you've kept forgiving this person. You try to overlook this person's ways because you love them so much. You know, the Empress loves unconditionally. I feel really stressed with this part. Oof, my chest. Tell me more about this King of Swords. Why would he want to hurt group? Why did they want to hurt group two? Six of Cups, Eight of Pentacles. Tell me about the Six of Cups. Tell me about the Six of Cups. Queen of Pentacles. Oh, that was strange. You can't actually see that. I don't think you can. No, it's not in shot. My candle, I've got a candle, if you can see my hand, just here. And it literally just sparked. I don't like this energy at all. I'm feeling really, like, funny with this energy. I don't know how you lot coped. Just bear with me. Tell me about... I was going to ask the Three of Cups. The Fool in reverse. Because I'm seeing a reconciliation here, okay? I'm seeing that somebody's feeling nostalgic about the past, okay? A lot of memories, dreaming about the past, you know. And then the Three of Cups can be reconciliation as well. But then we have the Fool here. Tell me about the Fool in reverse. Oh, stop throwing them out. Tell me about the Fool in reverse. This person neglected you. They were very negligent. Three of Wands. They, when you're in the relationship they, with this person, you know, this, I am picking up strongly that this was a relationship, okay? Some of you, it could be work, someone you work with, but I'm picking up more so relationship. This energy here has huge regrets for how naive and stupid they were, okay? You were unprepared for a person like this to come into your life. You wasn't prepared for this toxicity that came into your life. Like I said, I was really young and dumb. I wasn't even prepared. I'd never experienced anything like it again. To be honest, I'd rather be battered than to be treated like, be abused mentally, okay? And this is what I'm getting for you guys. Now, so yeah, you were unprepared, naive. You wasn't expecting this kind of energy to come into your life. It's like you didn't know how to deal with it. But this person was so reckless when it came to your heart, reckless when it came to the way they treated you. They didn't care. And it's like now this energy is saying that I wish I can go back. Maybe do it differently. Maybe go back because I haven't got my fix here in mistreating group two. You know, I get a kick out of it. That's what I'm getting. So it's like now they're missing you. So we do have Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn as well. They're willing, okay, and some of you may not even want to hear this, but this is what's coming out here. They're willing to work really hard on getting you back, okay? Fixing things between both of you here because they see the value in you now. They didn't see it then. They didn't see, you know, who you was back then. But would you really want to go back with somebody like this? Tell me about this King of Swords. Six of Wands. They felt... They felt powerful, you know. Every time they did something to you, they just felt this, they got a buzz out of it. And it's like they had to do that because they had to make themselves feel powerful, you see. Tell me more about this King of Swords. Actually, let me do that again. That's too many. Tell me about the King of Swords. Oh, come on, Spirit. I'm going to take them. Sod it. Oh, God, we'll be here all day. But anyway, let's just take these. Okay. So we do have the Knight of Pentacles. What did I say? I would be very surprised if the devil doesn't come out in this reading, and here it is, the devil, the Wheel of Fortune, the Page of Wands, I can't see without my glasses, Ace of Pentacles, the World and the Six of Swords. And we do have 333 here as well, so look up angel number 333, okay? There's a message there for you. So I wanted to know more about this King of Swords here. This person abused you for a very long time, okay? They may have even worked up to it very slowly, you know, lured you in with a false sense of security, okay? That I'm, you know, wonderful and I'm such a nice person, you know, what people do. And then boom, that's when the devil energy came out here. And this is when they started abusing you. But like I said, they abused you for a long time here. Spirit is saying you were dealing with a karmic here, okay? It could be a karmic from previous lives, you know, like a soulmate from a previous life, you know, that follows you. And it's like when you got with this energy here, Spirit is saying that your fortune turned for the worse. It wasn't for the better. This was like a big mistake here. Not of your doing, obviously. So you could have been dealing with someone that was emotionally manipulative, controlling, mind games, narcissist, you know, someone who had drug addictions, sex addictions. Just the devil is just an awful energy. And with the wheel here, I do seriously believe this King of Swords follows you through many lifetimes. Hopefully you've broken the cycle now. You know, if you've left this person, the cycle's broken. And then we do have the Page of Wands and then the Ace of Pentacles. You know, you started noticing, you started seeing the truth when it came to this energy here, okay? You started seeing what they were really like, and you know, you decided that you can't go through this anymore. You know, you had to close this chapter. You learned something very, very valuable when it comes to never putting up with something like this again. Okay? It was a life lesson that needed to be learned. So there's you with your Ace of Pentacles. You went off. You may have moved away. You may have even moved country to get away from this person. But you started again somewhere else, away from this person. You got another chance to do it again. Yes, it turned your world upside down, but that's what needed to be done. You know, your life is so much peaceful now, like more, so peaceful now. You don't have no problems. You have these silly little problems, but you don't have this problem here. So the reason behind this energy here, the reasoning behind it was because they love the thrill that they got. You know, the Six of Wands is victory. It's like feeling like so powerful. And that is like the devil energy as well. So we do have Capricorn, Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn as well. We do have Leo, Aries, Sagittarius. So tell me about the devil energy here. Three of Swords, that broke your heart. Tell me about the devil energy. This person broke your heart. Tell me about the devil energy. Always stubborn when you want to clarify the devil. Queen of Cups. Ten of Swords. Yep. You know, you love this. Look, 9, 10 of Swords. This is completed. This is over. It got to the stage with this devil energy that you said, I am done. This is it. I'm out of here. Because they broke your heart over and over and over again. Okay, they cause you anxiety, sleepless nights, tears, stress, worry, grief. They betrayed you here by treating you this way. You know, it could have been abuse as well with the Ten of Swords, you know, violence, aggression. But yet you loved this person unconditionally. You've come out as the Queen of Cups as well as the Empress. You didn't want anything from this person other than to be treated right. Alright, let me ask the question that I asked in group one. Does this, well, we do see a reconciliation here, but I want to know, do they regret? So tell me, Spirit, does this energy regret treating group two this way? Do they have any regrets? Two of Swords. Ace of Swords. Queen of Swords. Five of Swords. Ten of Wands. Yep. Yeah, I'd say we even got. They try to block out what they did to you. They don't want to face what they did to you, okay? But it's like, I feel like Spirit is actually haunting them, you know, maybe haunting them through their dreams here. It's like they can't avoid it. I feel like it creeps up every now and again. And I feel like this person is quite confused as, why did I treat my Empress like that? I don't think they even understand. I don't think this person's even gotten themselves any help to understand, you know, like some therapy, you know? The truth has been revealed to them, okay? They see the truth for what it is. That they treated you like absolute crap. They know they caused you pain. Some deep, deep pain here. They know they abused you here with the Five of Swords. That is abuse. But now, every day, this energy here has to carry around the Ten of Wands, which is burdens. Having to carry around the guilt, the memories of what they did to you. So, yeah, they're being haunted by this. But they try and avoid it. They try and ignore it. But I feel like Spirit's like, I'm going to show you exactly what you did to group two. So, yeah, this is a horrible energy, group two. You know me, I'm honest. Let's have a look. Tell me more about this energy here for group two, please, Spirit. So, look, your answer here is they got a kick out of it. It's some kind of thrill. I think it gave him some kind of even sexual satisfaction here. We do have the Devil. There was something very wrong with this person. And it's just so sad that the Empress got, you know, you guys got stuck with this person. So we do have Careless. I didn't see your worth until it was too late. You didn't deserve that. Would you forgive me? And that is exactly what I said. They want forgiveness here. They see the value in you now. How valuable you was to them. But, guys, I don't know whether you've noticed here in this reading, we only have a couple of cups out. There is no love here. This is all mind. We've got so many swords here. This is all messing with the mind. Then we have unavailable. I know you're a catch and I love your company, but I just want to have fun and keep my options open. And that is what I was saying about. I feel like this person would say to you, right, we're done. No, come back. We're done. No, come back. And I feel like it was this in and out energy with you guys, you know, messing with your mind in that sense as well. Wanting you 1 minute, not wanting you the next minute. Immature. I ghosted you because I wanted to teach you a lesson. Okay. Fear. My friends are a bad influence on me. I worry about what they'll say about us. So, yeah, maybe they had some toxic friends that, you know, go out drinking, getting smashed up, you know, getting up to things that they shouldn't, you know, be getting up to. I'm going to get a couple more for you guys. Rejection. I felt my advances were recuperated. So maybe they've tried to come back. Maybe they have tried to reconnect with you and you have rejected them. And good for you if you did. So what else did this energy do to group two, Spirit? Oh my good God. Okay, seems like they did a lot. Not so many this time, Spirit. Oh, for goodness. Do you know what? Whatever. Let's take them. It's sneaky behavior, seduction. They are trying to seduce you. Hopefully it's not just physical. So maybe they're being sneaky at the moment. Maybe if they try and come back into your life, just be wary, guys, okay? This is not a good person. I don't say that lightly sometimes, you know. Unlicensed sex shop, cheating, fetish, craving. They're about having their one specific fetish sexual act. And I just said to you, this is like a fetish. This is like a this abuse gave them sexual satisfaction, guys. Honestly, that's what I'm really am picking up, and that's come out. Secrets, embarrassed by you. They're embarrassed to claim you, be around you in public, or be in a relationship with you. So maybe that's how they treated you as well. Manipulation. They twist the facts by altering reality with lies or misstatements in order to confuse you. This is exactly what... Look at the snake. This is exactly what I said right at the beginning of the reading. This is what they would do to you. So then we have control. They are trying to control you because they don't trust you. Projection. Cheating. Habitual cheating. More heartache in the future. So this person could have even cheated on you guys as well, okay? Argumentative. They love to argue and create drama where there is none. Yeah, so maybe they'd start arguments just for the sake of starting an argument with you. You know? I know what I am doing. There you go. I play dumb to keep you confused. Jesus. I take that as a clarification as well, that stupid noisy bike. I've got the window open, it's been a hot day today, so yeah, I'm sitting in the loft, is really hot. Oh my god. Okay, it's gone there. So basically, like, you know, I was about to say thank you to Spirit for clarifying what I was saying right throughout this reading. I know what I'm doing. I play dumb to keep you confused, you know? Like, what am I doing? It's all you. It's all in your head. I am finally seeing my worth, yet I still feel unworthy of your love. Oh, good for you, mate. I don't feel guilty for how I treated you. My ego is too big to care. And exactly, they don't feel guilty. It's like, yes, they've been haunted by it, but they avoid it. They don't want to face it. They know what they did to you. They see the truth in what they did to you. But it's just like, are you doing anything about it? No. I think of you at night when the world is asleep and my mind is awake. I was afraid that you would reject me if I shared my feelings to you. That's just crap, sorry. Because look, here we go. My focus is on my life. I can't be bothered to worry about you. This is where the manipulation comes in. So one minute they'd have all these little sweet words and the next minute it'd be an attitude like this. So let's get some oracle cards. So these are for you guys, okay? Peace. I am a being of love and I release all negative energy, and Spirit is saying, please be at peace with this. Don't let it keep going on and on and on in your mind, okay? Don't let this person into your energy like that. You know, I know it's hard to let go, but you deserve peace, okay? Then we have purpose. I know what I am here to do. So maybe this was, you know, something that you've, like I said, there was a life lesson that needed to be learned here. Yeah, life lesson. Maybe you found your purpose now. Health. I will honour the physical vessel that enshrines my soul. So maybe your health suffered really badly with this energy here, okay? They made you ill. Maybe you lost weight. Maybe you weren't eating correctly. Your mental health. So Spirit wants you to look after your health. You've even got self-esteem here. I possess gifts of the soul that benefit me and others. So do not let this person, even if you're not with this person, you haven't been with this person for years, your self-esteem most probably still is at a low, because, you know, maybe you think back to this person and that will affect your self-esteem. But Spirit is saying, don't let that happen with this energy here, okay? Let's get a message from your angels. So we have Archangel Raphael. I am helping you heal physical challenges in yourself and others. You are a healer like me. So you've got one of the archangels protecting you, okay? This is a healer. So Archangel Raphael is actually helping you heal, as well as you. You know, you're the divine feminine who has healing energy. So, you know, that makes sense, really, you having an angel like that. So let's get a little boost for you from my love sketches. Back together. Oh my god, this came out in part one. You find your way back to each other when the time is right, and you will soon realize the space that was created was to allow your love to take a different form. Look, some of you, like I said, the group one, this may not resonate, okay? It may be that you, some of you, you know, like I said, found a little man, may want to get back with this person. For most of you, I don't see it somehow. Cold peace. What exactly do you love about him? If he's treating you in a way that feels disrespectful, ask yourself what part of you allows this behavior to continue. Spellbound. Caught up in your spell. Just be careful what you wish for. Your manifestation is coming. Is it truly what you want? Maybe some of you are missing this person. You are wanting to get back this person. Just be careful, guys. Okay? Be very careful, because this person hasn't learnt their lesson. So let me get this straight. You want to go down that path again and repeat that same cycle all over again. Tell me you're joking. Yeah. So guys, take that as a warning, okay? I mean, come on. Wise up. Begin to understand the truth of the situation, even if it's difficult and painful. Spend time alone to help bring clarity and make peace with them. And that could be why, guys. Look, I'm not having a go at you. Everybody's got free will. We all make mistakes. We all go back until we learn our lesson. Self-esteem. There's a reason this is on the back of the deck. It's because you need to love yourself, okay? You need to respect yourself. You, when our self-esteem is at such a low, an all-time low, people like this can come in and actually take advantage of us, okay? Because we don't value ourselves. So this is what the spirit is saying right here. Please value yourself. Please love yourself. So that's for some of you, not all of you. So think of a question, guys. Ask a question out loud. Think of a question and let's see what spirit says. Might be. So that's a might be. Let's do it again. That's like a maybe. Definitely not no. Zero chance. Okay? So, yeah. Anyway, group two, I hope you enjoyed this reading. I hope it resonated. If you like this reading, please hit like. It helps the channel. Comment down below. Love hearing from you. And you have a lovely day. Much love, guys. Hey, group three. So if you chose the pink and yellow owl, this is your reading. Oops. Killing that owl. So let's have a look. So spirit, tap me into group three, please. And tell me the person on group three's mind. Why did they hurt group three? So we have the sun, the star, yep, the star, seven of swords, eight of wands, and the tower. And then the four of swords on the back of the deck. So we have the sun and the star here. Bear with me, guys. confused. Maybe this person was confused. Because you brought them a lot of happiness and peace, okay? It was like you were a wish come true, you know? Some of you may be someone that's in the limelight, okay? You know, stardom quality, you know, platform, influence, that kind of thing. But there was something very suspicious about this energy here, because we do have the Seven of Swords. Now, the Seven of Swords is someone that is a liar, can be a cheat, being sneaky, trying to get away with something. And then we have the Eight of Wands with the Tower, which is communication, you know, messages going backwards and forwards. And they cause a Tower moment in your life. I keep hearing that they thought you would be able to fix something for them, heal something here. The energies have been all like really weird tonight. Tell me about the Sun and the Star. Why did this person, Eight of Cups, Nine of Cups, oh, hang on. Okay. I'm seeing what I'm seeing. Now, bear with me. Tell me about the Seven of Seven of Swords. Just bear with me, guys. I just need to clarify this card. Tell me about the Seven of Swords. We have the Queen of Cups in reverse. Tell me about the Seven of Swords. This person cheated on you. That's all I'm going to say right now. Tell me about the Seven of Swords. This person could have even got someone else pregnant, okay? Or could have got pregnant by somebody else. Tell me about the Seven of Swords, please, Spirit. So we do have Aquarius, Leo. We do have Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces, Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn. Come on, Spirit, tell me more about Seven of Swords. Oh, this energy. Thank you. Okay, finally got somewhere. Which is a lot of cards. So we do have the Knight of Cups, Two of Swords, Ten of Pentacles, Chariot, Temperance, Empress, the Devil, yep, the Fool, yep, the Magician. This energy went off with somebody else here, group three. So, you know, the question is, why did they hurt you? You know, why did they treat you the way they did? Because they knew they could get away with it. Okay? That's the attitude that I've got. It's like such a blasé attitude. It's like, I don't care. They didn't care that they caused such devastation in your life, you know? So for some of you, not only did they leave you, they could have got someone else pregnant. Because we do have the Empress here. This person went off, and I feel like it was financial as well, because they were getting a better deal here. And I know that sounds really cruel, but they were getting a better deal out of the this connection that they had with somebody else. And, you know, the Queen of Cups in reverse is talking of somebody that is unfaithful, you know, they can't keep it in their pants. Someone who's very weak, very needy, very sulky, spiteful. You know, and I feel like they were weighing up their options, okay? They were going backwards and forwards with who do I want to be with? Who's the better option for me? So I feel like they were actually carrying on an affair for quite a while. It wasn't something that happened very quickly and then they left. This person rejected you, okay? They abandoned you. They left you in the Five of Cups, which is, you know, heartbreak. The Devil and the Fool. This person is only out for themselves. You know, this person has a family with this whoever they left you for, okay? They do. Whoever they got involved with, or if they're in, if they're the one that comes for money, these two are financially set. They've got family together. But I feel like that's what lured them in, was financial reasons. Person is a very clever when it comes to manipulating people. You know, this is the Seven of Swords here. This is what clarified the Seven of Swords, about someone that's being sneaky, cheating, lying, you know, being deceptive here. You know, you thought this energy as well was somebody that, you know, everything that you've been hoping for in a person, it was like, it was just an illusion. It was. This person wasn't fully committed to you. And I don't feel like they're actually fully committed to whoever they're with, unless it's turned toxic, because I do want to clarify this Devil here. So we do have Capricorn. We do have Sagittarius. What else we got? We have Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn. And Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces. Okay. So let's have a look. Tell me about the Devil. Tell me about this Devil energy. You know, if you've been questioning yourself, why did they hurt you? Why did they treat you the way they did? I mean, like, you know, some of you may have already known about this, but maybe you just want to know why. I'm telling you why. Is because of the Ten of Pentacles. They knew this, they were getting something out of this, and it could have been, maybe you didn't know that they got someone pregnant, or someone was pregnant, if you know what I mean. Tell me about the Devil energy, please. Yeah, Three of Cups. This party. Tell me about the Devil. The High Priestess. The Hierophant. The Wheel. And the Two of Wands. And the Five of Wands. The Spirit is saying, okay, because I'm clarifying the Devil, this relationship is not happy. Whoever they got involved with, it's not a good place that they're in. This has turned toxic, okay? These two, maybe, I feel like your ex, this is an ex, okay? All piles come through as exes. It's codependent on the person they got involved with, like I said, financial reasons, because they were greedy. Because don't forget, the Devil is all about greed. Now, you know, the Three of Cups is all about reconciliations, as well as friends, celebrations, as well as third parties. But this is a third party situation here, and Spirit is saying this person didn't use their intuition here. They didn't use, you know, we all have a gift here of using our intuition, and they didn't use it properly. You know, they're married to this person, okay, or in a serious commitment, but Hierophant is marriage. But they've got involved with a karmic here. Karmic energy they're involved with. These two, bad news. Bad news. They made a bad choice, is what Spirit is saying here. And now there is a lot of problems in the relationship. Yep, a lot of problems. This has turned really toxic between these two. I feel like there's violence in the relationship with these two. A lot of arguing, a lot of fighting, bullying, aggression, abuse, So if your ex here was abusive towards you, just know that they're doing it towards the other person. But I do feel like it's both. Both are actually doing it. So, you know, at one stage, you did make this person happy. They did see you as, you know, a wish come true. But then somehow they met somebody online that changed the dynamic, changed things for them. Okay? They're the ones that caused the tower moment for themselves as well as you here. And they were being sneaky about this. And this is what, I feel like it was going on for a long time. I don't think it was something that was happening overnight. Maybe you found out about it and then finished with this person. Okay, group three. So, you know, this is the reasoning behind it, is because money, pregnancy, the lifestyle that they wanted. And it's just, this energy was just very selfish. Like, I'm just out for myself, basically. I mean, for some of you, this person could have even ghosted you, okay? You know, not even any communication, just up and left one day. So tell me, Spirit, does this energy feel, are they sorry for how they treated group three? Are they sorry? Oh. So what do we have? We have the Queen of Wands in reverse. The Nine of Wands. The King of Cups. Oh, yeah. They are very sorry. Very sorry. The Lovers. Justice. Oh, I love it. Absolutely love it. Wow. We even have the Lovers, okay? We have Justice. We have the Ten of Wands. And then the Ace of Swords. And from these cards here, oh, it's a very strong yes here, okay? We have the Queen of Wands in reverse. This is always seen as the other woman or the other man, okay? Especially if it's a third party. So they're actually telling you here who, they didn't get the Queen of Wands upright. They got the Queen of Wands in reverse. This is somebody who is a bully, okay? Very jealous, very manipulative, spiteful, controlling. You know, is not faithful herself or himself. So this is someone who is just as promiscuous, or, you know, this is seen as a Jezebel. So this person's having to put up with their partner cheating. Okay, so they say what goes around comes around, does it not? You know? And then we have the Nine of Wands, which is them feeling wounded. They've been wounded deeply by this person. You know, they've tried to put boundaries in place with this person that they're involved with, but it's just not working. This person just doesn't care. But they're having to go with it, persist in the relationship, because I feel like they're stuck now. You know, they now want you to know, their energy wants you to know that they did really love you. You know, they regret that they didn't choose you here. They regret not starting a family with you and a home life with you here and having their happily ever after. They see that you was the happily ever after. And like I said, now the Two of Wands, I've just looked over there, even though that was already there, this is the bad choice that they made. Okay, they chose wrongly here. They chose a karmic here instead of you, who is the, you know, the real deal here. This is like, now they're sitting there thinking, oh my god, this is an injustice, this, how can this happen to me? I mean, oh my god, you know, woe is me energy. Okay, so we do have Gemini energy as well. And yeah, Ten of Wands. So we have the Nine of Wands. We have the Ten of Wands here. And this is somebody that is carrying around a lot of burdens, a lot of weight, too much responsibility. Family life may be getting on top of them. The relationship may be getting on top of them, which we did see that with the Five of Wands and Five of Swords. They're exhausted. They're stressed. It's like they've had enough. And then we have the Ace of Swords. They see the truth for what it is now, but it's too late. The truth was that they should have chosen you. They should have stayed with you. They should not have cheated. They shouldn't have chosen the Jezebel here. But what can you do? Nothing. Yeah, nothing. They chose money, wealth, someone who may have used their body to get what they wanted, you know. The Jezebel, she or he likes to, you know, likes to use the assets that were given, okay, you know, to lure people in, but then that's just an excuse. So let's get you some oracle cards. So tell me, spirit, what more does this energy want to say to grapefruit? What have I got there then? Oh, sneaky card. Page of Cups, that doesn't even belong in this. Why is that even in there? I didn't even use these cards. This is somebody that offered you the world, basically. This is in here for a reason. But we're just full of empty promises here. You know, they offered you a fish. And this is the thing as well. I feel like the Queen of Wands in reverse offered them the world, but they got a fish as well. So this is someone that is very childish, okay? Just not fully mature at all. So tell me more, please, Spirit. Unavailable. I was using you as a distraction to get away from the other person. So this could have been somebody that they were already involved with or hadn't got over with, and they started communicating again, okay? So they were never available to you. You know, so get a bit more information here of why they treated you the way they did. Immature. What did I just say? Page of Cups. Immature. I just loved the thrill of the chase. Once I knew I had you, I lost interest. And I do feel like this is the case down here as well with the person they're with, but they're stuck. They're stuck. Money means more to this person. Hurt. You said some things that really hurt me. Oh, boo-hoo. God's sake. I'd say some things and all. If you hurt, you know. This is our childish... I'm really sorry. I shouldn't laugh. I really... This energy is making me laugh. This is how childish this energy is, you know. Page Cups. It's like the childishness is even coming out in this reading right now. By literally saying to you, you really hurt me from some of the things that you said. You most probably did say a lot to them once you found out the truth. I mean, seriously, what did they want you to do? It's like, okay then, see you later. You know, have a good life. Doesn't work that way. Circumstances. I had a lot of responsibilities. I didn't mean to ghost you. I'm afraid to contact you now and be rejected. Now, I did say that for some of you, okay? This person may have ghosted you, packed their bags and just left. You don't even know where they went, who they're with, what's going on. I feel like friends and family won't even tell you what is going on. But now they're wanting to reach out, but they're scared you're going to reject them. But be careful, because they're still involved. They've got nothing to offer you. You know, Page of Cups is somebody that doesn't have anything to offer you. It can also be an apology. They want to apologize with the Page of Cups. But is it a genuine apology, or is it a fishy apology? I smell something fishy. Circumstances. There was a series of unfortunate events in my life. I had to disconnect from the world. It wasn't just you. So, you know, it could have been, like I said, the pregnancy for some of you. Narcissism. I like to play mind games to make you miss me. Ugh. Unavailable. I know I had to make a decision, but I wasn't in a good place to do it at the time. I hope you can understand and forgive me. You caught me in a lie and I was embarrassed. So, you know, some of you may have actually caught this person talking to somebody else online. Or, you know, third party. There are feelings of anger inside me that I need to release before I explode. But that is the Ten of Wands and the Nine of Wands right there. I am distracting myself to avoid thinking of you. I know what I am doing. I play dumb to keep you confused. I am afraid that your feelings for me are not mutual. Oh, My mask keeps me safe. I need to fake my feelings. There's the magician right there. I said this person wears a mask. I need to free myself from fear and doubt. I am a caged bird. And I said that this person is just trapped. But this is what they wanted. This connection bores me to death. I need something more exciting. But that's the problem. This energy is like, doesn't have the ability to remain faithful to one person. You see? They get bored. Then we have, I'm keeping secrets from you and I hope you don't find out. But that's exactly what they were doing. But it also could be, like I said, some of you don't know why they left, okay? Like I said, some of you, they could have just up and left and you've had no contact with this person. You don't know why. So now they're saying to you, I hope you don't find out. So let's see what else this energy wants to say. Bad motives. Scheming. They are making secret and underhanded plans. And that is the Seven of Swords right there. Control. Their controlling behavior comes from their insecurities. Bad traits. Anger problems. They have a lot of pent-up unresolved anger issues. And so this person could have lashed out at times with you, you know. No reason at all. Just for breathing the wrong way, you know. Bad motives again. Using you. They only need you when they need something. So some of you, this person could come in and out of your life, you know. Some of you may still be involved with this person, but you don't know the truth. You know, for some of you, like I said, this person's married. Maybe you guys are not aware of that. But that's only for a small number of you, okay? Let's do that again. We have lies, lies, lies. Control in an effort to control your behavior. They lie to you. Secret. Living in the past. Could be they haven't gotten over an ex or something from the past. It's affecting your union. And that's exactly what just came out there. There was someone that they never got over and they started communicating with again. And yeah, I feel like you were just being used in the process, you know, like a rebound. Manipulation. This manipulator will make you feel special by telling you what you want to hear. Exactly. They diminish your problems and play up to their own. Backstabbing. Careful who you trust. They're up to no good. So, you know, this person could reach out, because this is a message card here. They could reach out to apologize, but don't trust them. It's not genuine, guys, at all. So let's get a message from Spirit for you guys. Doubt. I release the need to know all the answers. Okay, maybe you're doubting yourself. Maybe this person, if they're still in your life, they communicate with you, makes you doubt yourself. Spirit is saying, don't doubt yourself, okay? And sometimes we don't need all the answers. We have death. I'm learning that endings are merely beginnings. Yep. So sometimes things have got to, you know, come to an end for a new beginning. That's what death is all about. So let's get a message from your angels. So group three. Oh, goodness. Okay. You lot got three. And I can't put my cards on the right way. We've got Adriana. I am leading you towards the answer to your prayers. Please listen to and follow the steps I am communicating through your intuition, thoughts and dreams. So she is saying, please listen to me. So she's leading you to all the answers that you've been seeking, okay? What you've been praying for, group three. So listen to your intuition, listen to your thoughts and listen to your dreams. Then we have Ashtara. You deserve the best. Reach for the stars with your dreams and desires and don't compromise. Exactly, you do deserve better. Celeste, a happy move to a new home or place of employment is in the works. This movement will usher in positive new energy. So, we do have the Ace of Pentacles on the back of the deck. And this is a new beginning. We did have the Ace of Pentacles. No, that was in the other group. So, you know, the Ace of Pentacles is all about new jobs, moving, new home. So this could be what you're, you know, what's coming up for you guys. So let's get some love sketch cards here for you. Bit of advice. Love offer. A new love offer is on the horizon. Keep an open mind. It's the only way you can explore, create and grow. Progress is impossible without change. So be prepared. There's a love offer coming in for you guys if you're not with someone already. Opposites. Perfect is an illusion. The two of you might be total opposites, but in that way you complete each other. You have more in common than you think. So whoever this love offer is coming from, it's total opposite of what you're used to, okay? And they say opposites attract. It could even be someone that was never your type, but spirit is saying broaden those horizons, you know, have an open mind. You may surprise yourself. Then we have memories. Embrace the beautiful memories, but don't spend too long holding on to them. Stay present and enjoy where you are now in life. So yeah, embrace those memories, but yeah, don't keep going over them, you know, because sometimes you keep that person in your energy as well. Stay grounded. Take a step back and be fully conscious in the present moment to align your soul to your true self and help you control your emotions. Look ahead. Leave the past where it belongs. Look forward to what's coming next. Something better is waiting for you, I promise you. Okay, so guys, you know, this is really, really positive here. Spirit is saying, yes, have your memories, but don't obsess about them. You've got a love offer. You've got someone that's totally opposite to you. Stay grounded and look ahead because something better is coming in for you guys. So group three, I'm going to leave it there. If you like this reading, please hit like. I appreciate you guys. Comment down below. Love to hear from you. And you have a lovely day. Much love, guys.